Hello and welcome, everyone. We're back in Sea of Thieves. I'm doing some more Ledger stuff tonight, because, I mean, why not, right? Let's see, there's a skeleton fleet. There's a storm nearby. If it goes like it did Friday, it'd be great. Oh, good. They're grade 4 and they're like right next to me. Daggertooth. Okay. Well, I'm sure I can see them from here. Looks like a sloop. See here. Check my rep. Tall tales. All that's done. Love it. Let's see. Grade 59 and the Reapers. No ledger recording. I'm close to getting everything in that tier. I'm way behind on the gold hoarders. I think I've got. What is it? Yeah. And am I even further behind on the order? Yeah. I'm even further behind on the order of souls. I got the ship sets and I was like, ah, that's enough. Not as worried about that. The Hunter's Call. Athena's Fortune! Ooh, Legend! Only 23,000 below where I currently am, though. That's not good. I need to bump that up. As long as this ship doesn't become a Grade 5 Reaper Emissary.
Stand a bit closer, would you?
Just do trophies first. I just want to see if I've unlocked anything new. The Hunter spoils. Shots fired. These are all fish. And I can't get any of them until I get, like, let's see, like, Amber Plentyfin. Unlocked by reaching class 10 in the Plentyfin's Caught Pirate Milestone and earning the grade, okay, grade 1 Hunter of the Amber Plentyfin. So grade 1, and then it's grade 3, grade 4, and then grade 5. So you just have to get Plentyfin's Caught. And then the commendations for each specific one unlocks that. I think all the rest of these are fish. Yep. And this is just random crap.
See you, mate.
Are you guys still over there? Yeah. They're moving. Where are you going? Okay, they're sailing. Storms are rolling in.
Who's there? Mind your step.
What's up, Captain?
Resources and commodities. Gonna be a mistake because they're gonna see me and they're gonna come after me, but the rep boost is definitely worth it. And I will have spent all of that gold on nothing because I will have sunk. But we'll see. How are you doing? Pretty good, yeah. Storm here. A bunch of chain shot here. I like that. Yep. Keep setting it down to make sure I'm not, like, full on fireworks and crap. ship in a second and check on her. Well, I don't get stuck on these rocks. A few more barrels up there, but I'm gonna leave them. What's up? How's it going, Zach? It's got some rainwater in her. Nice. Oh, you know, just doing this. Nothing much right this second. I can put down.
It's good to see you. The quest to embark on is
a lot has changed.
Glory. It's about protecting the life we hold dear.
Crooked masts.
This is the Veil of the Ancients. It holds the power to open a permanent doorway to the Sea of the Damned. With this power, the boundary between our Sea of Thieves and the Sea of the Damned is no more, and memories can become real. However, to use this power, the Veil must be reunited with three stones that were taken from it long ago. There are others seeking the stones, so you will need to act fast. Retrieve the Veil stones, and I'll make sure the Veil of the Ancients never falls into the wrong hands. Everything you need to know is in your quest book.
Yep.
Good luck.
There's Crooked Masts.
Counting on you.
I'm trying to stay out of the storm for as long as I can. Yeah, they've got, I guess it ends this week. They've started doing... So they closed down the arena, which was the PvP arena. They shut that down completely. And now all the super sweats that played that roam the sea just begging for a fight. So that causes some issues, but... So less than 2% of the player base even, like, got into the arena when they decided to shut it down. So... Right, they were contained for a while. I mean, it's not any worse. It's just... Like, it's not more frequent. It's just... The number out of those... Like, if you take the percentage of encounters that are going to end with a battle, it hasn't increased. It's just the chances that they're going to be, like, super toxic, raging assholes. That percentage is it has gone way up. It's like, me and Scala were playing on Friday, and we ran across another ship, and we battled them for an hour. You know, there wasn't any of this, like, chatter yelling back and forth at each other, or you'll get some folks who will just, they'll basically drop your anchor and raise your sails so your boat can't move, and if they've damaged your ship enough, they'll actually repair it. they'll actually repair your boat and then just sit on it and wait for you to respawn and murder you over and over and over and over again. I had that happen a couple of times. And then you just scuttle your boat and you move on, you know. You still run across them. There's a lot of folks who just want to fight, but they want to do it in a fair way. No, you get nothing for that. The only thing you get is the satisfaction of standing there and stabbing someone in the back when they spawn over and over and over again. No experience increase. Just a huge waste of time for everyone involved. Well, I guess the person doing it gets to feel superior. You know? Yeah. Which, most people who roll up on you and just murder the hell out of you are doing it to get whatever's on your boat. And you'll get some people who will get on your boat and go, oh, there's nothing here. There's no reason for me to attack you. And they'll just stop and sail away. There's some ships that have rolled up on me and I'm like, hey, look, I'm just fishing today. I have nothing on my boat. You can board me and look for yourself. And then they just roll up and sink me. I'm like, okay, well, I tried to tell you. Now they do, every few weeks they do, like, an adventure that delves into the story a little bit more, since they've done that. I think that ends this Thursday, is the Herald of the Flame, where, Stitch and Jim from the Tall Tales, which, also, story-driven, or narrative-driven storylines, you know, those were good. Right? I get it when people show up and they're like, okay, I'm here for all of your gold and I don't care what you have to say about it. And then they realize that you have no gold. And they just proceed to murder you. There's a ship nearby. They're flying the Reaper's Emissary flag. Which means if they get to grade 5, they'll be able to see where I am, because I have an Emissary flag raised. And the Skeleton Fleet is still active, so they're either not doing that, or they were after something else. Bell, are you in here? Oops, sorry, snake. Don't spit venom on me. Hello? No, she's gonna be at the actual tippy top. Or she's in a weird spot. It's gotta be one of the two. Alright, don't fall off. Belle, I need to talk to you. I need the special spooky lantern. Hello? Oh, she's up there. Ow. How the hell do you get up there? Like, nope, not like a Skyrim horse. Thank you. Appreciate it, Snake. Maybe like a Skyrim horse with a little bit of brain damage. Hup! Nope. I didn't get there. Aha! Alright, Belle, listen, I need to talk to you. I need that lantern. I gotta go check my boat, see if it's full of water. Because it's raining.
Take this. It will reveal along the bottom narrow. Light the braziers and they will lead you to the jewel. And power allows you to glimpse events that happened long ago. But it
yes, yes, I know.
Draw the attention of those that serve may not.
Statue. Alright, this is they're gonna work. I'm gonna die horrifically. Alley-oop! Oh! Ow. Oh, I can hear my bones clacking together. Oh, I got struck by lightning! Okay then. Well. That'll do it. I can get those sweet LED lanterns for my boat. Okay, I would love to respawn. Sometime this evening, guys. Thank you. Now there's an active leak in my ship, I think. No? Okay. Disregard. Mistaken. Come on, DJ, get out of my way. Right here. Yeah, that one's good. Nope, don't you do it. Spit venom on me. I didn't look to see where the Reapers were. They did. They really wanted to kill me. Well, I said it was gonna work or I was gonna die horrifically. And I made a liar out of myself, but Rare definitely took the opportunity to make it the truth. The last one. Okay, now there's the one down here. I got a light. Yep. Oh yeah, I died, so I came back to my ship. It does the whole, look, it's a captain's ship. It's still grade 4, they're still fighting. Oh, there's another Reaper crew coming in. Be on the other side of the island. Right? Yeah, there's the crooked mast between me and them. Which I did on purpose. I gotta see if I can see the ship. Because I need to know what's going on over there.
Where our ancestors dwell.
Yep.
Hear our call.
There's birds, probably. Barrels of plenty, or it's a shipwreck. I can't see them through the rain. Oh, I tagged somebody, Vendor's Voyager. I can't see them though. Okay, well.
Where are our ancestors now?
Here goes nothing.
Hear our call. May the worlds be joined once more. Let the veil be. Get a star.
Ow.
Keep away. I fight for me true.
Watch it, snake. Well, there can't be that many of you left. Oh, God. Okay, there was a gunpowder barrel somewhere that somebody set off and wiped us out. Or, well, me anyway. I know I'm in the middle of something. I don't want to stop to go see where the ships are. Has the Soulflame captain spawned in yet? No, not yet. Here. Tried to set him on fire. Didn't really. Okay, he's dead. Thanks for the stuff. Appreciate it. The overlapping music gets a little weird sometimes. Treasure chest or anything yet. So I just have to carry these tiny things one at a time instead of putting them in a chest. Looks like the storm has moved on. Oh, nice. There you go. Hear that?
You fought well.
Yep, thanks.
I sought to reconnect the two worlds once.
My dog sneezed. My video game dog, not my real dog. I don't know where he is. He's somewhere in the house. Being a weirdo. Okay. Gotta drop this off.
You can tell me all about your adventures. But now, we must find the next Veilstone.
Please send me away from the double grade 4 Reapers that appear to be battling each other. Storm. Okay, so that's where the world event is. That's a skeleton galleon. Died. Shipwreck graveyard. Awesome. East of Hidden Spring Keep. Oh, good. Oh, good. And there's more Reapers on the server. It's just spectacular. That's what I always wanted. Okay, well, let's just sail north. Let's just sail to Daggertooth. Let's do that. God. It's definitely not yay. You know what? I need to collect the treasure. It's very important that you take the treasure that you picked up from the adventure and put it on your boat. Well, it depends. If it's a galleon or a brig, no, because the content won't be, there won't be much content. It will just be me getting completely and utterly crushed under the weight of a larger crew. I know one of them's a sloop, because I saw their boat in the distance. Don't do that. wanted to unlock my phone, and it was like, here's that free magazine thing that we do. I was like, no, I just wanted to unlock my phone. I don't want to look at that. I never want to look at that. No, I do not want them. Especially when it's not even a real magazine, it's just that thing that my phone does if I swipe. If I'm at the home screen and I swipe to the right, it pulls out this thing. It's like, hey, you know all that content that you don't ever read, but we want you to read here. Read it all in one place. Maybe you'll read it then. So, no, I haven't even set you up. There are two great four ships there. Ugh. I don't want to be close to these ships. I'd much rather be on the opposite side of the map from them. Oh, there's a brigantine. Great. If I get totally wrecked, I'm just gonna do a fishing stream. Problem with this is there's where I need to be. This particular thing, I have to be underwater for extended periods of time, not paying attention to ships around me, which means they could very easily just roll up on me and sink me before I ever had a chance. What side of my ship are you going to be on? The hell was that maneuver? Is there a megalodon over there or something? I don't understand what's happening. I just realized I left my wood crate and my cannonball crate at the outpost. Actually, I'm going to keep this mark here. I've never seen that happen before. Back. Just as quickly as they left, they're returning. Does that thing have hydrofoils? Too much to hope they've got gunpowder barrels that I can just detonate. Looks like yes. It's a direct hit on the mast. Ship there. The mast. How much wood do I have? Okay, good. A lot. Capstan's damage too. They were definitely sunk doing that world event. Okay. We're just gonna sail back west. I have never seen a skeleton ship that spawned like that. Because, like, the ones that just show up, that are hanging around on the sea already, if you roll up on them and you initiate combat, they'll eventually leave you alone if you get far enough away from them. The ones that spawn on you will hunt you down, and I don't know why this one didn't. Unless they've changed that in a recent update. Don't tell me that's where I'm going. It's probably Keelholeport. I hope it's Keelholeport, not Hidden Spring. Looks a little too far away to be Hidden Spring. It's the Brigantine. And if they hunger, they'll be coming for me. Against a ship with a, like, going up against a brig is even if most of the crew focuses on sailing the ship in naval combat, they can just keep throwing one guy at me until they get him on the boat and he kills me, and then that's it. Which, speaking of, go ahead and get a defense plan set up. So the way this is supposed to work is you pull up here to this shipwreck. You go into the wrecked ship and look for the logs and see where they sent the key. Then you go to that ship and you find the key and then you move on. You know, fairly straightforward. The way I normally do them is I just... Yeah, these are... So this is specific to the quest that I'm doing. It's got a... It's a three-part quest. There's a... They've got, like, four different types of quests that it has in circulation, and it's a three-step process. So it gives you one of those out of the pool, and then it gives you one of the other kind. And then the last step is always you go to a big ghost tornado that has a fortress under it that summons two smaller fortresses, or three smaller fortresses that you then destroy, and it makes the big one vulnerable, and then you destroy it and you get a bunch of loot. As far as the lore is concerned, there's a lot more to it than that, but that's essentially the way that the quest works. Let's see. And now I've got this. The key is safe aboard the Golden Star, so then you go find the Golden Star, and you find the key, and you unlock the treasure room on this one. And then there's, when they first started adding the new content for the season, like, they started doing seasons. Season 1, they added in a Merchant Alliance voyage where you sail around looking for the shipwreck of a merchant vessel. And there you get the captain's key, and you can get into the captain's quarters and get their shipment, and basically turn that in. That's how you get the most rewards. Basically, the way to end the quest, end that quest, is to just find the manifest and sell that back to the merchants. But since I've got that brigantine nearby, I mean, it's not super close, but they're grade 5, so they'll be able to see my ship on the map. I want to just get this unlocked, and what I'll probably do is just sail somewhere and sell what I've got. That way I can try to get a little bit of a boost to my emissary grade, and get a little bit of gold before the ship comes after me and tries to sink me, because it will. There's a lot, well, not a lot more. There's usually several more pieces of loot stashed around. But because I'm in kind of a rush, I'm not going to bother looking for it. They're on the move, but it's not towards me. That just means they saw a juicier target closer, I think. Going to do the world event because there's another ship already there. just sail east. Trash pieces. Not gonna be worth a lot, but they'll be worth more than nothing. And if that other ship is still not there, I'll go back and see if I can reclaim my supplies. Chase somebody to plunder outpost. Yep, that's what it is. Tabitha's packing up the apartment. We're moving soon. We'll be moving closer to work for the both of us. Live about 20 minutes away from work right now. The next town over. And because we work for the company that runs the apartments, we get a discount, so that's also nice. Everything. Sure looks like it. Well, that's fun. so I at least get something for my troubles this evening. That's good. Now, I still have this one jewel here. This is part of the Shroudbreaker. That's for the Tall Tales. For the Veil of the Ancients. Server? They did. Or they lowered the emissary flag. Either way. We're gonna sail over to Galleon's grave and see if there's anybody there, and if I can claim that crate I bought earlier. And also, hopefully, the next place we'll be going will be right next to that. Take the dog to the vet tomorrow. Ugh. Better than the cat, I suppose. At least the dog doesn't fight me. And I don't end up with, like, $500 vet bills when something goes wrong. So that's that. Stupid nickels. That's okay. I still love that little fluff monster. No. But there's some. In. And then if I'm correct, and the location of where the ghost tornado shows up is based on where you, like, if you're in the wild, it's in this place. If you're in the Shores of Plenty, you're over here, you know. Then, if I'm right in that, then this event should pop up right next to this outpost. If I'm wrong, I'll have to sail back in the other direction, probably against the wind, and announce to the server for much, much longer that there is something worth stealing here. So, there's that. Flag and oh, there's a storage crate. Captain's logbook. Captain of nameless ship. Oh, you're... no problem. Nichols is coming to investigate that door being open. It's like, another forbidden room. My god. It's just a closet with nothing in it. That's all it is, Nichols. Go away. Nichols. Come here, Noodle. Come here. Come here. Come on. What the? You weirdo? I said, come here. Fluffball. I'm just gonna sit right there then? Is that how this is gonna work? Okay, that's fine. Okay, good. I got my supplies. Because if this goes anything like the last one, it's gonna be rough. Well, the best thing about moving is I'll pack up the computer and then I'll actually sit down and, like, clean my keyboard. It's good to know you can fish and float in the water at the same time. Because that keeps happening. Northwest of Crescent Isle. That's literally the other side of the map for me. Ugh. Great. Hey, I see you over there sniffing that. Don't cut your eyes at me like that. You can come sit in my lap and I'll rub on you. I'll give you little ear scratches. Nichols is still laying on my desk. He's just out of camera range. He's upset because I'm not paying enough attention to him. Set us due west. I'm gonna hop up for just a second. Where are you going? Are you going over to the other chair? There you go. Can't even play a shanty, I'm just drifting. South, for some reason. Of course it would be on the literal opposite side of the world for me. and the wind shifted too. Great. Not very good. Just keep on keeping on. West of Crescent Isle should be basically dead ahead, just a ways off. But you can see events like those from clear across the map. Oh, there it is. I can barely see it, but it's there. What is that? Thank you. skeleton galleon over there. It's a trident. Player galleon. To the southwest. Nobody flying anything. It's dangerous. Ooh, careful. Watch it, don't hit K9. Okay, I'll make myself another drink. I will be right back. Class 2 minutes spent sitting. It's a sea post we're gonna sail by. Rum runner. Rum runner. Quarters upset that you're not in the bed. Ship. Helping me out. taken off course. Basically hold on to it all the way over there. Kraken. Come on, you damn squid, where are you? Tell me you're in places where I can't get you. That's rude and uncalled for, Kraken. Water in the boat. I want to know who put two pieces of shark in there, each with a bite taken out of them. That's just incredibly rude. Is there more than one piece of treasure out here? Well, sort of. I'll take the thing that has barely any value compared to the thing that has almost no value. Come in here. Sounds close. Thank you. sound like it's coming here. Close enough, I've got the music now. Galleons. Oh God, that ship's gonna collide with us. It. Prepare the boat. Bucket the water out. Much quicker than this, though. Coming up on the next emplacement. Oh, turn too tight. We're gonna run into the big tornado. the big fork can't shoot at you while this is happening. It's a collision. It's a ghost boat collision. Come on. I've got the place in range. Oops. I've got the fort in range. I can blast it, take it out, and destroy the galleons that are also shooting me. Looks like I'm gonna have to stop at the fort and pick up supplies, though. All the holes? Nope. There's one over by the fire barrel. Great, the world event is not very far. Okay. Let's get rolling. I just have to get this one little fort. And the big fort is ready. Goes. Now we have the fortress from beyond. Now I have to get in the danger zone, squeeze myself between the fort and the patrolling galleons. You can sink the galleons, but they just keep throwing more at you, so I mean it's at best a temporary relief. Like that. Ooh, okay. All right, that one was a direct hit. It's a good shot from that one. Take care of this one first. Am I out of cannonballs? hear it spitting. There it is. Fix him up. Are you kidding me? Just bash my head to the wall right there. Nope, bad fort. Grab cannonballs? Yep, full up. We have a couple of spots left to destroy. There she is. Fort's done. There's still a hole somewhere, but it's a small one, so. I like that when you defeat the fort, you can't go inside of it, but they just take all the treasure and set it outside the door with basically a note that just says, okay, you won, go away. Taken. There are no other holes. Well, that went well. I should have held on to all of my loot, but, you know, what can you do? If I hadn't, then all those Reapers on the server would have come after me. So. That's what happens when you play risk versus reward. Thank you. guess I barely have the wheel turned. I can hear the ship grinding against the side of the fort. Ugh. Slightly turned. Getting some stuff.
Well now, that was an adventure worthy of a true legend. I'll see what they will say for the sound. Who knows? I may even call on you to use its powers before too long. Your adventures will be forgotten here and in the Sea of the Dam. Dark times ahead. But pirates like you on my side, I feel confident we can protect our life from those who seek to destroy it. But what is the Sea of Thieves but a haven for those with adventure in their hearts and mischief in their souls? Here's to you and all that you've done for this strange and wonderful home of ours. Cheers!
Thanks, Ramsay. That's weird. Why can't I raise the anchor? It's because it's already up. Duh. Stop until these pieces are cracking. Undercooked. Not quite there yet. My ship.
Who let you in my galley? This chicken stuffed pig with banana sauce or cider.
There's a sloop over yonder. I'm only class 3 in plenty fins caught. Oof, it's gonna be a long, drawn-out one. Okay. Looks like two sloops jammed into each other. Looks wrong. Is there a... There is. But I don't think that's what they're doing. Sails are all the way up, so let's go ahead and get the anchor. And we're straight on. There's a ladder inside the tent, but why not? almost got it all. Go. Now it doesn't look like I have anything else I need to mark off. Let's see. Sweet. Commendation unlocked. That's worth a good little bit. Okay. There we go. Okay. I'll be right back again. Milestones. 36 plenty fins. Need four more to get to class 4. I can see stats now. I've earned over 1 million gold as a Merchant Alliance emissary. And I've been a grade 5 Merchant Alliance emissary for 417 minutes. Athena's Fortune emissary, I'm class 7. As a grade 5 emissary, it's been 266 minutes. It's been 40 minutes as a grade 5 Reaper's emissary. And I've earned 168,000 gold. Well, I got an hour and a half. Fort of Fortune just spawned. I'm right next to it. I'm going for it. Worst case scenario, I lose my emissary status, and, well, I don't quite care about that right this second, so. Weapons. All right, Fort of Fortune. Let's do this. Sloop's still over there. God. Mm. Pretty sure they hit the cat stand. They hit me. They hit the mast. The wheel. There's almost no wood left on the wheel. That's just shredded. Oh, come on. Oh my god! Just let me fix my boat and move! Finally, he's dead. Jesus. Mask got hit twice. Still blown apart. Oh god. Is anybody sailing for me? Are you kidding me? Oh my god. All right, new plan. I'm gonna regroup. Because they're about to sink me. I'm just gonna sail away from them. I'm gonna fix my boat. Because I'm just sitting here fixing the same four spots over and over again. It's completely and utterly worthless. Blowing my whole friggin' boat apart. Like, the capstan, the wheel, the mast. I'm surprised I still have a boat at all. Why are they such sharpshooters? They're never this good. I've got 4 million planks because I've already used 40 of them. Just sitting there trying to get to where I can go do battle. Good God Almighty. There's so much water. Come on, fix it. Jesus. Is that all of it? Okay, I think I'm in a spot where they don't realize they can shoot me. I think. It's phase two. Is now climb up top and check to see where other ships are. Because I definitely saw one. Damn it, I was trying not to explode every powder keg on the island. Every skeleton in the game manning cannons. Missed. Oh God. A lot of explosion. Now, and I'm on fire now, too? Jesus. Chill out. And they're all healing because they're skeletons. They're. Almost. Because they're skeletons. Because they're plant skeletons. That's not helpful in any way. Stop. No, 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 no. Did he at least explode? I don't know. Maybe. Save wood needed for repairs. Oh, I wish I had a rowboat. Sometimes there's one in the middle of keelhaul fork like this, but there definitely is not right now. Am I stuck? What the hell? Don't care. Come on. That wave exploded, and it's a new set coming after me. Well, at least some of them did. That's problematic. Holy Jesus. What's that ship doing out there? Ship over there, very close by, with an emissary flag. Let me see if I can get a little closer and see if I can spot what it is. Oh, and there's a galleon too? Oh no. Galleon's firing on the sloop. May just be a target of opportunity since there's doesn't appear to be anybody on that sloop. My hope is that everyone will be like, ugh, Ford of Fortune, and just roll on. I don't think that's gonna happen. These things are a pain. Galleon looks like it's, well, I can't tell. It looks like it's sitting there. Watch out. The galleon's over there. They just sunk somebody else. Oh shit, I don't know what this guy's doing. Thank you. Looks like he's just sailing by.
Is it smoke detectors?
Sounds like it. Galleon's just parked over there. He must just be going to Smuggler's Bay. Pieces of shark, and I'm gonna need 50 pieces of kraken. What are you doing? Are you hoping to score just a little bit of extra treasure from that ship that was parked there? Look, your big boat is very intimidating. I'm gonna go ahead and swap to my blunderbuss. Twice the wind blown. Okay, well, that's good. Going anywhere. I know as soon as I get started on this, they're just gonna sail on in, come just annihilate me. Where are you? Where'd you come from? Tiny regular skeleton? Ow. Thank you. Ow. Jesus. And it's also possible that the galleon is just waiting for me to complete the Fort of Fortune, so it can swoop in, kill me while I'm moving the treasure, and take all the treasure. It's highly possible. Sadly, right now that seems like the most plausible, since it hasn't moved at all. Moving now. It's sailing over here. Trust this for a second. Those look like, that looks like the Royal Revenge set, which is a very popular PvP set. Yep, that's what it is. Okay, time to move. Sitting still will only hurt me. Kidding me? Let me return to the ship, please. Capstan got hit. I can't tell what they're trying to do. I'm trying to give myself some sort of terrain advantage, use the maneuverability of my sloop against them, but I can't tell what they're trying to do. I don't know if they're trying to move in and do the fort, or what it is that they want to do, because I just can't tell. It looked like they were trying to chase me, so I was going to try to sail over here. Alright, new plan. I can go do the fort, but with them lurking around, they're just gonna come after me again. So I'm gonna sail parallel to them towards Smuggler's Bay and see if they try to get in a fight with that other sloop, and if they do, I'm gonna try to swoop in and blast them. Unfortunately, that means using the other sloop as bait. Somebody at the Reaper's hideout, flying just the Reaper's mark. Oh, is that little sloop? That's the sloop, little Fetty or whatever the name is. Okay.
trying to sail to you to help you.
Sail around Smuggler's Bay. Come on, sail back this way. Set off a signal flare? Yeah. Faster. Oh, and there's a skeleton galleon too. Oh no. Skeleton galleon, go after the galleon. They dropped their anchor? Oh, they're just moving real slow. The whole sloop is booking it. skeleton galleon shooting at me now, though. Which is problematic. Didn't matter. They were gonna come after me regardless. I would have been fine if that damn skeleton galleon hadn't hit me with an anchor ball. That ruined everything. Because then my wheel got damaged. I couldn't fix the boat fast enough and move fast enough. It just... it did not work. I know my boat's gone. Am I at Smuggler's Bay? No, Crescent Isle. Okay. I was like, then stick me at Smuggler's Bay. That's just rude. Well, I don't have enough time to do much. So, I'm gonna catch some plenty fins. Excuse me, snake. Pardon me, snake. Excuse me, one more earthworm. Please? Hello? Grubs. Grubs. No. Not what I want. Get away from me, Splashtails. What the hell? How hard is it to catch a plenty fin? I'm in the Shores of Plenty. I have earthworms. Let me give the bait a wiggle. punched the cat in the face. I bumped the chair. Catch three more to get to class four, so I have to catch at least three of them. And then I can turn them into the Hunter's Call. Get credit for them. Give me a trophy bone dust plenty fin. Yeah, give me that. No, you don't. Come on. Come on. Two more. Another amber. I'm not gonna complain. Yeah, so the reason I stopped doing the fort once I chased the galleon and lost, and really the reason I was chasing the galleon in the first place, is the last time I successfully completed a Fort of Fortune, it took me 2 hours. 2 hours. So, it's not a quick thing. Like, at all. And because of that, I didn't want to get most of the way through the fort and then the galleon come rolling up on me and sink me. And then, you know, all that work's undone. And also, because the last time I did it, it took me 2 hours. There was only 40 minutes left in the stream. And I hadn't even made it to the... So the way the fort of... The way a regular skeleton fort works is... The skeletons spawn. A bunch of different waves. A bunch of different skeletons. You kill off all the waves. And then... The... boss spawns. And it's either... the Duchess... The Mutinous Helmsman... And there's two more. I don't remember who they are. It's been a while. But there's four of them. pretty sure it's four of them. Well, you defeat them, they drop a key, and you open the fort, you get the loot, and you go. And then there's an Ashen Lord, which, if you watch the Herald of the Flame fight was essentially just an Ashen Lord fight. They're just a big ol' annoyance. Just like a regular skeleton boss, but they can summon fire and throw firebombs and rain hellfire down from the sky. You know, that kind of stuff. And that's important, because the Fort of Fortune is a regular skeleton fort. So you get to the boss wave, but it spawns like three or four of this of the bosses for the fort. You kill them. They all die. Then it spawns an Ashen Lord that you have to defeat. Once they're defeated, they give you the fort key. And then you're visible on the map for a little while.
They're rough. They're worth it.
Ooh, a watery plenty fin. This should be the last one I need to get to the next class level. I'm class 3 there. Yay, class 4 and plenty fins caught. Cool if there was a hunter's call chest that doubled as a grill. I don't know that it contains like some special fishing lures are in it. You know. Some stupid made up lore crap. Cause there's the cursed chests. But one of them's not really cursed. There's the
Chest of Sorrow, which cries.
And fills your boat with water while it's crying. There's the Chest of Rage, which gets hotter and hotter until it explodes in a fireball and sets your boat on fire. Then there's the Chest of 1,000 Grogs, which, when you pick it up, you instantly get drunk and it plays Drunken Sailor. But if you walk up to it with a tankard, it gives you the option to fill your tankard. Which is neat. So it'd be cool if there was a chest that you could, like, stick some wood in, and you'd have a second grill on your boat for doing Hunter's Call. And you turn it in for, like, Hunter's Call rep. I don't know how that would work. Hell, you could even do it where you gotta shove wood in it to keep it going.
Oh.
Lost my LED lanterns. Palette swap. Port of Fortune's gone. It despawned. Go ahead and sail for the spoils of plenty. The store. We'll sell the fish that I'm cooking. We'll go back to the fort that was the Fort of Fortune, because I did manage to pick up some treasure maps so we can get something for our trouble. Yeah, I know. It's just a motorcycle by Nichols. Was following us around today, yelling at us. This Tabitha's been packing the apartment up, getting ready for the move. Ooh. Hey. Cool. That means. Means we are gonna go check that out. I'm gonna put one of them on the boat. Maybe like rag and bone crates, which you have to take to a specific place. If that's the case, we'll just drop them off at the dock. So I've gotten legendary Voyager and legendary Hunter. Although the legendary Hunter is entirely thanks to Scala. At least I can get something for it. Won't be much. That's better than literally nothing. Ooh, an ammo crate. Boy, howdy. That was the first wave of skeleton bosses. That's right, it'll count towards completing found quests. Gunpowder barrel. Just what I've always wanted. Skeleton sleep. Oh, you know what? I do need to check something. Weird. So, defeat the Shrouded Ghost. Oh. Legend of the Sea of Thieves. Defeat 250 skeleton ships as a pirate legend. Got 178 of 200. Wait, are you sailing away? Yeah. Thank you. reason to detach the rowboat like that. Rather than trying to force... Oh, hello. You are, sir. The reason I did that was so I could read this. Come on. I love that there's a rowboat dock. Pay to repair my ship. I'll do that later. I'm sorry, Nichols. I didn't mean to disturb you. Shh. Nichols is very mad because I dared to sneeze. Carefree shanty rogue. The lurking terror. Well, I guess that's good that I haven't made it to class 40 in the ill-fated yet. Oh. Well, I just did that. Almost maxed out the Voyager. I think they go to 100. I don't know if it keeps counting after that, like for bragging rights. I just hit 40 in the ill-fated. I'm only two slots higher in the emissary than I am in the rogue, and I want the emissary stuff for the Schoonhound. Stream for the evening. I want to thank y'all for dropping by and checking it out. I'll be live again tomorrow from 7 to 9 p.m. Eastern Time. Make sure you drop by and check it out. I do also have a YouTube channel. It's basically just an archive for the stream. It's literally all it is. I do post some like chopped up videos and shorter clips there, but if you're interested in that, check it out. I do also have a community Discord. There you can hang out, chit-chat with me, and I post announcements about the stream. But that's it. Thank y'all so much for dropping by and checking it out, and I'll see you next time. Bye, everyone. Have a great rest of your night.